Good morning, children. Today we are dealing with the concept division under the topic the fish tail. First, we shall know how we can divide the numbers ending on 0 by 10, 100, 1000 and their multiples. So the first example, dividing 130 by 10. This number is ending in 0 and we are dividing it by 10. So we can write it as 130 divided by 10. So whenever we are writing 130 divided by 10, you can see this is an additional 0, this is an additional 0. So in each we can cancel 1 0. So now it becomes 13 divided by 1. Anything divided by 1 remains the same. So 13 divided by 1 is nothing but 13. So here the answer becomes 13. Similarly, dividing 240 by 30, you can see 240 divided by 30, the 0 here and the 0 here, which is common, can be cancelled. We are left with 24 divided by 30, 24 divided by 3. So you can repeat the table of 3 till you get 24. 3 8s are 24. So the answer is 8. 3 8s are being 24. The answer is 8. So here the answer becomes 8. Similarly, when we are dividing 15,000 by 300, you can see here, two zeros and two zeros here are common. Of course, there is one more zero here, but this is not common here. So how many number of zeros are common, those many zeros we strike off. So we are left with 150 divided by 3. So you can say the table of 3 till you get 15 and add a zero to it. 3 fives are 15. So 350s are will become 150. So the answer here is 50. Similarly, some examples are given for you to divide and solve. So you can divide 2500 by 50. Here you can see there is 10 and 10 which is common. So you can strike off this 0. So you will be left with 250 divided by 5. So 5 5s are 25 and an additional 0. So the answer should be 50 here. Similarly, when you are dividing 3600 by 120, 10 is common in both. You can cancel. So here you are left with 360 divided by 12. So when you say the table of 12, 12 threes are 36 and a 0. So the answer will become 30 here. And in part C, you can see two zeros are common in the dividend as well as the divisor. So you can strike off these two zeros and these two zeros here. You'll be left with 18 divided by 9. So 9 2s are 18. So the answer here becomes 2. 1800 divided by 900 is 2. Now we shall learn dividing the numbers 3 digit, 4 digit and 5 digit numbers by 1 or 2 digit numbers. This is not half. By one digit number or two digit numbers. So here I am dividing a three digit number, that is 135 by 9. You can clearly see when we have to divide 135 by 9, we will write 135 here. This is the dividend and this is divisor. Remember, the number which is divided is called dividend and number which divides is called divisor. So we keep the dividend here and divisor comes out of the bracket. Now we'll take the first digit 1. 1 being smaller than 9, you cannot divide 1 by 9. So we have to take two numbers here. So we will take 13. Two digits we'll have to take, and we say the table till you get a number nearer to this number or equal to this number, not more than this number. It should be either smaller or equal to the number here. So 9 ones are 9 and 9 twos are 18. 18 is bigger. So we have to take 9 ones are 9. So now we subtract 9 from 13 and we are left with 4. 10, 11, 12, 13. So 4 is remaining here. Now we pull down the next digit here. So this number becomes 45. Now you say the table of 9 till you get a number either equal to 45 or just less than 45. Just less than 45. So 9, it's clear that 9 5s are, you get 45. So 45 minus 45 becomes 0. So whatever answer you get here, this is called remainder. And the number here is called quotient. So we have first dividend, which is in the center, here divisor, this is quotient, and after subtracting, whatever number is left over here is called remainder. And always remember, children, this remainder should always be less than the divisor. Is it clear? Now we shall look into another example here. We will divide 748 by 7. We are dividing 748 by 7. So 7 ones are 7. Remainder is, sorry, when you subtract you get 0. Now you pull down the next number, that is 4. But 4 is less than 7 here. So what we do? We write 7 zeros are 0. Without dividing, we can't proceed to the third number. At a time, you can scroll down one number. So after scrolling down this number, if this number is not divisible, then we write zeros are. So 7 zeros are 0. Any number multiplied to 0 is 0. So you get 0 here. Then 4 minus 0 is 4. Now you scroll down the next number, that is 8. You are getting 48. So you keep on saying the table of 8 till you get a number equal to 48 or just less than 48. So clearly 7, 6 are 42. Okay. So when you subtract, you get 6 because 7, 7s are becomes 49, which is greater than 48. So one number preceding we take, that is 7, 6 are 42. When you subtract, you are getting 6 as the remainder. Here the dividend is 748, divisor is 7, quotient is 106 and remainder is 6. Children, the question which I have put here is different. Please, you can strike off this and we will continue with this particular question itself. The dividend here is 748, divisor is 7, quotient is 106 and the remainder is 6. Now we'll take another example, dividing 1975 by 12. So first, since this is two digit number, 12, that is divisor is two digit, we'll have to take two digit numbers at first. If this two digit is smaller to this, then we can take three digits. But 19 is more than 12, so we can write 12 ones are 12. 12 twos are becomes 24, which is bigger than 19. So we'll write 12 ones are 12. 19 minus 12 is 7. Now we can scroll down only one number at a time. So we'll scroll down 7. You'll get 77 here. Now you say the table of 12 till you get a number equal to 77 or less than 77. So 12 fives are 60, 12 sixes are 72, 12 sevens are 84, which is bigger than this number 77. So 12 6 are 72 we can take. Now you subtract. 7 minus 2 is 5 and here 7 minus 7 is 0. So you are left out with 5. Now you can scroll down next number, that is 5 from here. So you get 55. So you again repeat the table of 12 till you get a number equal to 55 or less than 55. 12 4s are 48, 12 5s are is 60, which is bigger than this number. So 12 4s are 48 is a correct number. So we take 12 4s are 48, 55 minus 48 is 7, and you can see 7, this 7 remainder is less than 12 here, and no more number is left here. All the numbers are exhausted. So we finish here. This becomes the quotient. So again, 1975 is dividend, 12 is divisor, 164 is quotient, and 7 is remainder. Coming to the next question, we have 10,905 to be divided by 25. So we will write the dividend in between, then we'll take the divisor here. Now you say the table of 25 till you get a number equal to 109 or less than 109. So 25 ones are 25, 25 twos are 50, 25 threes make 75, 25 four makes 100, and 25 five makes 125, which becomes bigger than 109. Okay, so I'll take 25 fours are 100. Why didn't I take these two digits? Because 10 is less than 25. So I'll have to take three digits here at a time. Therefore, 25 fours are makes 100. I'll write here 100. Then I subtract 100 from 109. So here 9 minus 0 is 9. 0 minus 0 is 0. 1 minus 1 is 0. So you are left out only with 9. Now you can scroll down only one number, that is 0. Now 25 threes are makes 75 and 25 fours are makes 100, which becomes more than 90. So 25 threes are 75 is correct one. So when we multiply here, we borrow 1 from 9. So this becomes 8 and this becomes 10. 10 minus 5 is 5. 8 minus 7 is 1. So you are left out with 15. Now you scroll down the next number, which is the last number remaining. So you get 155. And 25 fives are 125. 25 sixes are makes 150. And 25 sevens are is 175, which is bigger than this. So we will stop here. 25 sixes are 150. When you subtract 150 from 155, you are getting only 5 as the remainder. And we are exhausted with all the numbers here. So this becomes the quotient. 436 becomes the quotient and 5 is the remainder. Now there are some problems for you. Divide these numbers and find out the quotient and remainder in all the three cases. These are for you to solve. Now we shall discuss some word problems here which involve division. The first one, cost of a dozen. A means one. In previous class also I told a, per, one, each. These all words mean one. So a dozen means one dozen. And how much are there in one dozen? A dozen means 12. Okay. So cost of a dozen of eggs is rupees 60. So 12 eggs are costing 60 rupees. What is the cost of one egg? So while solving this, we write the two quantities which are given. There are some eggs given, number of eggs and cost. 12 eggs are costing 60 rupees. So what is cost of one egg? So 12 egg is 60 rupees and one egg cost question mark. So again, we follow the same rule. Question mark is equal to 1 into 60 divided by 12. So follow this path. Question mark is equal to 1 into 60 divided by 12. So question mark is equal to 1 into 60 divided by 12. 60 ones are becomes 60. When you divide 60 by 12, you get 12 5s are 60 and remainder is 0. So the answer is 5. Therefore, cost of one egg is rupees 5. We'll look into one more example. Here, Kathy sells 15 kg of kingfish for rupees 1080. Kathy sells 15 kg of kingfish for rupees 1080. So there are two quantities given. Some quantity of fish in kg and price or cost. Okay. 15 kgs are costing 1080 rupees. For how much money did she sell 1 kg of kingfish? So, what is cost of 1 kg of kingfish? You have to find out. So, we'll write here 1 and question mark here. 15 kg, 1 kg, rupees. 1080 rupees here. And for 1 kg, how many rupees you have to find out? So, again, we'll follow the same path. Question mark is equal to 1 into 1080 divided by 15. So question mark is equal to 1 into 1080 divided by 15. 1 into 1080 is 1080 itself. You divide it by 15. So when we divide this number, see 15 sevens are makes 105. You are left with remainder 3. Now you scroll down one number at a time. So we'll scroll down 0 here. 15 twos are makes 30. So 30 minus 30 is 0. Remainder is 0. And quotient is 72. So cost of 1 kg of kingfish is rupees 72. Similarly, we shall look into one more example. A steamer. Steamer is a big boat with steam engine. A steamer travels a distance of 145 kilometers in 5 hours. So there are two quantities. One is distance in kilometers and time is given in hours. So I make two columns, time in hours and distance in kilometers. How much distance will it travel in 1 hour? So in 5 hours, it is traveling 145 kilometers distance. So in 5 hours, 145 kilometers distance, in 1 hour, how much of distance it is traveling, we have to find out. So here question mark is equal to 1 into 145 divided by 5. So you'll follow the Z path always. So question mark is equal to 1 into 145 divided by 5. 1 into 145 is 145. You divide it by 5. So when we divide, 5 twos are 10. We will not take only 1 here because 1 is smaller than 5. So we have taken 2 digits, that is 14. 5 twos are 10. 5 threes are becomes 15, which is bigger than 14. So we will take 5 twos are 10. 14 minus 10 is 4. Now you scroll down the next one number, that is 5. Next one digit. So you have 45. Say the table of 5 till you get 45. 5 nines are 45. So 45 minus 45 is 0. So quotient is 29. So this becomes the answer. So it travels, that is the steamer travels 29 kilometers in 5 hours. Distance of 29 kilometers in 5 hours. Likewise, children, I have sorted out some questions for you. There are 4 questions. First question, Florama sells all 25 kg sardine fish for rupees 1500. You have to find out how much does she sell 1 kg of sardine for. Second question, Nancy bought 12 kg potatoes for rupees 420. So for all 12 kg she paid rupees 420. So how much she'll be purchasing 1 kg of potato, that you have to find. Again, a motorboat travels a distance of 117 kilometers in 7 hours. 9 hours. So how much distance will it travel in 1 hour? So there are two quantities, distance in kilometer and time in hours. So for in 9 hours, 117 kilometers. In 1 hour, how much? You have to find out. Again here, same type of question. You traveled a distance of 145 kilometers in 12 hours. So again, two quantities, distance in kilometers and time in hour. So how much distance will you travel each hour? Okay. So for 12 hours, 144 kilometers. For each means one. For 1 hour, how many kilometers will you travel? So these four problems will be solved by you. And for now, that is stop it for now. And tomorrow we will meet with yet another new concept. Thank you, children.